Hello and welcome to another episode of Science Monitor, our show that brings to you the most significant news from the world of science, technology, innovation, research, discoveries and much more. I'm Aishwarya Kapoor and here are this week's headlines. India State of Forest Report 2017 reveals an increase of 1% forest and tree cover since 2015. The intensive wall-to-wall forest mapping exercise has been based on satellite data and ground verification. Government gives a major thrust to scientific innovation with the launch of the Prime Minister's Research Fellow Scheme. B.Tech and M.Tech students from India's top institutions can now get direct admission in the PhD program in IITs and IISCs. Dr. Daleep Kumar Upreti of CSIR National Botanical Research Institute, Lucknow, has been selected as Indian National Science Academy Fellow for his contribution in the field of lichen taxonomy. Great Talks, a lecture series organized by Vigyan Prasar in collaboration with the British Council, seeks to motivate students to take up careers in science. But first, our main story. The India State of Forest Report 2017 was released this week by Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister for Science, Technology, Earth Sciences and Environment. India's forest and tree cover has increased by 8,021 square kilometers, which is equivalent to 1% increase since 2015. India ranks 10th in the world with 24.4% of land area under forest and tree cover, even though it accounts for 2.4% of the world's surface area. Science Monitor brings you a special report.
On 12 February 2018, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change unveiled the India State of Forest Report 2017. The event was marked with the presence of Dr. Mahesh Sharma, Minister of State, Culture, Environment and Climate Change, and Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister for Science and Technology, Earth Sciences and Environment, Forest and Climate Change. The report contains national, state and district-wise information about the forest cover assessment and changes with respect to previous assessment. The India State of Forest Report 2017 is 15th such report in the series. This document is released every 2 years, attributed to give rise to the central government's conservation and sustainable management policies. There has been a consistent increase recorded in the forest cover since 2001. The Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has done assessment of forest cover for 633 districts using updated district boundaries. Also, the Forest Survey of India has been monitoring the forest fire for more than a decade now, and for more accurate fire alerts, the Forest Fire Alert System 2.0 was implemented in 2017. This helps in generating nighttime alerts, leading to significant reduction in the time taken for processing, improved resolution, and customized alerts. The spatial information given in the report is based on interpretations from Indian remote sensing satellite data with a spatial resolution of 23.5 meters. Satellite data for the entire country was procured from National Remote Sensing Center or NRSC for the period of October 2015 to February 2016. In addition, extensive ground data was collected by field parties at more than 18,000 points all over the country, and information from other collateral sources were also used to improve the accuracy of the interpreted image.
It is not like a routine report. Ye bahut hi meticulous dhang se, bahut hi scientific approach se, aur science ke jo latest tools hain, unka istemal karke banayi gayi hai. तो जब इस रिपोर्ट का मेरे सामने प्रेजेंटेशन हुआ और बताया गया कि 91 में ये सबसे पहले जब फॉरेस्ट पॉलिसी बनी उसके बाद से ये एवरी टू इयर्स वी डू दिस सर्वे एंड देन अकॉर्डिंगली क्या हमारा स्टेट ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट कवर है इसके बारे में वी शेयर इट विद द होल वर्ल्ड.
The report contains information on forest cover, tree cover, mangrove cover, growing stock inside and outside the forest areas, carbon stock in India's forests and forest cover in different patch size classes. According to the report, there is an increase of 8,021 square kilometer in the total area and tree cover of the country as compared to the previous assessment in 2015. The report for the first time contains information on decadal change in water bodies in forests during 2005 to 2015. There has been an increase of 2,647 square kilometers in the extent of water bodies in forest areas over the decade. The report also provides information on the total carbon stock. It is estimated to be 7,083 million tons, which is an increase of 38 million tons as compared to 2015. Additionally, an increase of 181 square kilometer in the mangrove area has also been recorded.
Overall, this sare vishay ko ek khali ek tree cover nahi but environment as a whole. इसको इस विषय को एक बड़ा देश में सोशल एंड नेशनल मूवमेंट बनाने की दृष्टि से हम लोगों ने एक गुड ग्रीन डील्स का मूवमेंट जो है देश में प्रारंभ किया है.
The information given in the report will serve as an important tool to monitor the country's forest resources and plan suitable scientific and policy interventions for its management. It will also serve as a useful source of information for the policy makers, planners, state forest departments and others interested in natural resource conservation and management.
The Union Cabinet on 8th of February approved implementation of Prime Minister's Research Fellows Scheme at a total cost of 1,650 crore rupees for a period of 7 years from the financial year 2018-19. The fellowship aims at emphasizing the importance of innovation and technology for the progress and development of the nation. Science Monitor brings you a report.
Brain drain has become a major concern for countries like India. It arises when large number of educated professionals migrate to other countries for better opportunities, for enhancing their careers, for better research and financial opportunities. This, in turn, creates a talent deficit in the country in important areas of technology, research, health, among others. To stem this tide and to provide an environment for research opportunities in India, the government took a significant step by implementing the Prime Minister's Research Fellows Scheme or PMRF scheme beginning from 2018-19. The scheme aims to tap the talent pool of the country for carrying out indigenous research in cutting-edge science and technology domains. This initiative of the government focuses on converting brain drain to brain gain. Under the scheme, those students who have completed or are in the final year of BTech or Integrated MTech or MSc in Science and Technology streams from either IISc, IITs, NITs, ICERs or IITs will be offered direct admission in PhD program in any of the IITs or IISc. For this, the students have to submit their articles, theses, review conference proceedings or any in-depth analysis of a particular subject to the nodal institute, which would be an IIT or IISc. A central project would be developed for uploading all the project by the students that will automatically send them to the nodal institutes or NIs. The candidates should apply on this portal along with their project within the time limit prescribed. The nodal institute or NI would then evaluate the student's project on the following criteria. The project abstract should clearly articulate the area of the study and should display keen interest and insight on the subject chosen. The project should formulate a problem for the study, which would be used for assessing the applicant's analytical and research skills. The topic chosen shall preferably be in technology and science with focus on national priorities. The students will then be called for an interview, where the selection committee will shortlist the candidates. After that, allocation of institute for the doctoral study is done, keeping in view the choices of the selected candidates and the availability of academic and other infrastructure. At the time of joining, each fellow shall be given deliverables to be achieved each year. This will be decided by the department in which the fellow is joining. The deliverables are to be designed keeping in view the topics selected by the fellow. There shall be an annual review of the performance of these fellows by the host institution, and the next year fellowship will be renewed only if the deliverables are achieved. Shortlisted students will be offered a fellowship of Rs 70,000 per month for the first 2 years, Rs 75,000 per month for the third year and Rs 80,000 per month in the fourth and fifth year. Apart from this, a research grant of Rs 2 lakh will be provided to each of the fellows for a period of 5 years to enable them to participate in international research conferences and present research papers. A maximum of 3,000 fellows would be selected over a 3-year period beginning from 2018-19. The research under the scheme will address the national priorities at one hand and shortage of quality faculty in the premier educational institutions of the country on the other. The initiative taken by the government will help in improving the quality of research in the country.
It's time for a short break, but when we return, we will meet Dr. Daleep Kumar Upreti of CSIR, National Botanical Research Institute, who has been elected fellow by the Indian National Science Academy, INSA 2018, for his contribution to lichen taxonomy. So keep watching Science Monitor.
Science can make a difference. Science can really change for the better other people's lives for a long time. But the truth of the matter is that chemistry is a very deep part of our lives with a very great benefit of human beings. The next discoveries in drugs, say, anti-cancer drugs, will come from chemistry. The way to clean up the atmosphere, which is a problem that exists all over the world, will come from chemistry. The way to solve our energy problems will come from chemistry.
Watch Eureka with Paul Walton, professor at York University, UK, only on Rajya Sabha TV.
रेल 65,000 किलोमीटर रेल मार्ग और 7,500 स्टेशन के साथ दुनिया का दूसरा सबसे बड़ा रेल नेटवर्क। रोजाना करीब 19,000 रेलगाड़ियां ढोती हैं 2 करोड़ से ज्यादा मुसाफिर और 25 लाख टन माल। 14 लाख कर्मचारियों वाली भारतीय रेल रोजाना दौड़ती है जितना धरती से चांद पर 4 बार चले जाएं इतना।
Welcome back after the break. Lichens. The slow-growing organisms usually seen on bark, leaves and rocks are of immense importance for studying climate change, soil quality as well as for medicinal purposes. One of the foremost experts in the field of lichen taxonomy, Dr. Daleep Kumar Upreti of CSIR's National Botanical Research Institute, has been elected as a fellow of Indian National Science Academy 2018. Science Monitor brings you a report.
Lichens form one of the most important components of our biodiversity. They are slow-growing organisms seen on the barks, leaves, and twigs of trees, soil, and rocks. They are formed by the combination of algae and fungi and have an irregular shape and size. These organisms are important in studying various environmental issues such as air quality and climate change. They also work as an effective early warning system to detect accumulation of metals in a particular area. Lichens also play a significant role in maintaining soil fertility through nitrogen fixation. Most of the species described by Dr. Upreti are widely used in various aspects like taxonomical and morphological studies, studying monumental deterioration, bioprospection, air pollution and climate change studies. Some such lichens are Cladonia indica, Filscum indicum and Pyrenula novagrandensis. The major hotspot area of lichen biodiversity in India are the Himalayas, northeastern India, Western Ghats, and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Dr. Daleep Kumar Upreti, who has been elected Fellow of Indian National Science Academy 2018, has identified more than 100 lichen species as new to science in India. Dr. Upreti's research has also contributed immensely on how the field of lichen taxonomy can help in solving environmental and human problems. Taxonomy is the scientific classification of organisms into specially named groups based either on shared characteristics or on evolutionary relationships as inferred from the fossil record or established by genetic analysis.
Once we had the idea of these plants, means we collected them throughout India. Particularly, we give emphasis to work on protected areas, that is biosphere reserves, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries. We have already carried out a lot of basic researches. Now we switched over to the applied aspects of this group. So we use these plants in biomonitoring studies, means with the help of these plants, we know the condition of forest or forest health.
Dr. Upreti has studied lichens from different regions of the country. He worked to modify the existing taxonomy in order to write a detailed study of different types of lichens. Dr. Upreti further utilized this taxonomic knowledge of lichens for conducting studies on pollution monitoring of different forests. In this, he studied forest health and its age structure on the basis of lichen bioindicator communities.
I started my career for the basic researches. So when we collect these lichens, or when we go to the fields, we collect those specimens, we bring them. On the one hand, we enrich the herbarium, means where the these samples or specimens of these plants are preserved. So we enriched our herbarium, and this particularly the National Botanical Research Institute's herbarium of lichens is well known. It is the largest collection of or repositories of these plants, not only in India, but in Southeast Asia. On the other hand, we started working on the most these environmental studies or climate change with help of these plants.
Dr. Upreti did his MSc and BSc from Kumaon University, Nainital, and a PhD from Lucknow University in Botany. For his outstanding research, he won the Professor B.A. Razi Medal in 2006 and a most prestigious award of MOEFCC Government of India E.K. Janki Ammal National Award for Plant Taxonomy in 2015 along with FNA in 2018. To delve more into the research of lichens, Dr. Upreti worked with several international institutes like lichenologist of Essen University, Germany. In his career span, he has handled more than 35 research projects and has published more than 350 research papers along with 13 books on different aspects of lichenology.
Vigyan Prasar, in collaboration with the British Council, has launched a lecture series called The Great Talks. Through this global platform, prominent scientists and educationists from Britain and India deliver lectures to educate students in different areas of science. The first of the talks focused on the important subjects of genetics and biofuel resource management. Science Monitor brings you a report.
Vigyan Prasar, an autonomous organization under the Department of Science and Technology, with its EduSat system in collaboration with the British Council of India, has organized a lecture series called Great Talks. The EduSat satellite, also known as GSAT-3, is meant for distant classroom education from school level to higher education. This was the first dedicated educational satellite that provides the country with satellite-based two-way communication to classroom for delivering educational materials. The sessions aim to provide a platform for renowned British academicians, scientists, and Indian students to come together and exchange knowledge in diverse fields of science. This lecture series was started on 9th February and will continue till March. The Great Talk also marked 70 years of British Council in India. The major objective of Great Talks is to motivate young Indian students to plan their careers efficiently by interacting with eminent personalities from Britain. In addition, this program will also help students clear their doubts in taking up any scientific career, widen their learning aspects by taking up different science streams, and finally to solve societal problems through science.
In Indian Science Congress, Prime Minister Mr. Modi emphasized that to secure the future, we would develop world-class scientists, technologists, as well as innovators. We should use technology for the direct interaction with scientists, children, and young.
In its first week, Professor Paul Walton from University of York, a specialist in the field of biofuels, interacted with students and delivered a lecture on the importance of biofuels in today's time. Along with it, he discussed the issue of equality for women in various fields of science.
We work in the area of biofuels, and particularly how we make biofuels from what most people would consider as waste or useless material. Grasses, paper waste, cotton waste. And in the past, it was very difficult to change that into fuel through fermentation. Our research is working on how we take those materials using enzymes and convert them through to sugar and then through to fuel. If we can do that and generate a completely sustainable fuel that way from those sources, it will address significantly the energy problems that we face.
Another lecture was on genetics, delivered by Dr. Turi King from University of Leicester. She discussed with students how genetics evolved over the years and how DNA is significant in studying the characteristics of humans. She also explained the fascinating relationship between the Y chromosome type and paternally inherited surnames, where she traced distant ancestral origins using DNA and surnames to track the signal of the Viking migration to the north of England. The results showcase that men with rare surnames like Grucock, Wadsworth, Ketley, and Ravenscroft tend to share Y chromosomes, suggesting a common ancestor within the past 700 years. The Great Talk series provides a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for young minds to expand their horizon in science and technology by giving them an opportunity to meet prominent figures and to explore new career directions in science. This unique initiative will eventually motivate students to advance in their scientific journey by taking small steps from now and to contribute to the world through their inventions in future.
It's time for a short break, and when we come back, we will bring you some more news on science and innovation from India and around the world. But that's after a short break, so keep watching Science Monitor.
साइंस कम्युनिकेशन यानी विज्ञान का संचार एक ऐसा माध्यम है जिसके द्वारा हम विज्ञान की बातों को समाज तक आसानी से पहुंचाते हैं।
Have to make films on science and technology, on environment. It's very important part of a society.
तो अगर फिल्म है, शॉर्ट फिल्म्स है, वो डेफिनेटली हमें ज्ञान देगा और हमारे जो एक थॉट प्रोसेस को हमेशा अलग रखेगा और हमेशा उससे सीखने की प्रेरणा मिले।
Welcome back. After the break, let's now take a quick look at some more scientific innovations and developments from India and around the world.
On 12th February 2018, in a press briefing on the subject of increased budgetary allocation to the science and technology sector, the Union Minister of Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Dr. Harshvardhan, said 10% as compared to last have increased by 10% as compared to last year's budget. Mission and facilitate formation of expensive and high-end machinery available in different institutions, labs and hospitals across the and high-end machinery available in different institutions, labs and hospitals across the country in order to optimize their usage. He emphasized the commitment to scientific social responsibility to promote grassroots innovation for the benefit of the general public. A four-member team, including an Indian engineer, Vikas Athai, has won the Scientific and Engineering Award at the Oscars 2018 Scientific and Technical Awards. They have won the award for the concept, design, engineering and implementation of the shoot-over K1 camera system. In this, the camera mounts get attached to the base of a helicopter, which carries the camera and lens. Its primary function is to eliminate any vibration from reaching the camera and thus getting steady footage. Researchers at the Delhi Institute of Genomics and Interactive Biology, or CSIR-IGIB, have used zebra fish to model the rare genetic disorder Rubinstein-Thiaby syndrome, or RSTS. This usually happens to 1 in 1 lakh people and causes intellectual disability, short stature, heart defects and broad thumbs and toes. The researchers have used two small molecules to partially reverse some of the defects caused by the disorder in zebra fish. There is currently no cure or treatment for the disorder. The results were published in the journal Biochemica and Biophysica at a BBA Molecular Basis of Disease. NASA's New Horizon probe has captured the farthest images from Earth by a spacecraft by clicking a picture when it was 6.12 billion kilometers away from Earth. New Horizons is the fifth spacecraft to speed beyond the outer planets. New Horizons were even farther from home than the NASA's Voyager 1 when it captured the famous pale blue dot image of Earth in 1990. Scientists at the Zoological Survey of India have discovered three new species of eel along the northern bay of Bengal coast. Dark brown with white dots on the dorsal side, Gymnothorax pseudotyle was discovered at the Diga coast of the Bay of Bengal. The other two species, Gymnothorax visakhanensis and Enchaiclicor propinquua, were discovered from the Vishakhapatnam coast of the Bay of Bengal. A description of all three new species was published in the journal Zootaxa. Scientists at the University of Colorado Boulder have developed a new self-healing and fully recyclable electronic skin that has applications ranging from robotics and prosthetic development to improve biomedical devices. Electronic skin, known as e-skin, is a thin, translucent material that can mimic the function and mechanical properties of human skin. The study was published in the journal Science Advances.
And in the history of science, this week we remember Charles Robert Darwin, born on 12th of February 1809 in Shrewsbury, England. He was famous naturalist, biologist and a geologist. Darwin is significantly known for developing the theory of evolution, which elaborates the biological changes in human beings with time. On 27th of December 1831, Darwin joined the HMS Beagle as the ship's naturalist as it set sail around the world. On this trip, Darwin studied different kinds of birds, plants, and collected fossils to study evolution. His theory of evolution was later called Darwinism. On 24th of November 1859, Darwin published the explanation of evolution theory in his book On the Origin of Species by Means of Natural Selection. In addition, he wrote several other books like The Descent of Man and Selection in Relation to Sex, and the expression of the emotions in man and animals. His final book was The Formation of a Vegetable Mold Through the Action of Worms. He passed away on 19th of April 1882 at the age of 73 in England. Well, that is all for this episode of Science Monitor. You can send your feedback and suggestions to Science Monitor on our email ID news@viganprasad.gov.in. You can also write into us at Vigyan Prasar C24, Kutub Institutional Area, New Delhi 110016. So we'll see you again next week with another episode of Science News and Innovations. Till then, goodbye and take care.